Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, if this is the first time you're seeing my face, hi, my name is Diana Mbuvi. If you've already subscribed to my channel, thank you so much for vibing to my content. If you've not subscribed to my channel, please just what is the reason why haven't you subscribed to my channel? Anyway, please subscribe to my channel if you've not subscribed, because once you subscribe, you become someone cool called a Glorium. You know, we just be glowing around here, as you can see. We are just glowing, meta, shining bright like diamonds. Anyway, I feel like this intro is gonna be so long. I'm really excited about today's video, guys. This is the first time I'm working with a company, like a hair company, a wig company that is not from this country. So Yolova Hair sent me, I hope I'm pronouncing their name well, they sent me this unit, and in the next clips I'm going to be showing you guys how I installed it and how I managed to get it looking like this. So that is announcement number one. I bagged a wig deal. Announcement number two. Quang 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 quang. Breaking news. So midway, when I was filming this video, I just went randomly, I checked my Instagram and saw that I have been nominated by Couture Africa under the Edge People's Choice Award, the females. My name is the last one in the list. My name is Diana Mbuvi, in case hijack hit badu. My name is Diana Mbuvi, so please vote for me. And with that being said, I'd like to say thank you to Myra. Myra is the one girl who mentioned me when, like, under their posts for when they were looking for people to be nominated. And then when she mentioned me, I was like, I feel like you've mentioned me in the wrong place. I don't think I need to be here, because other people are being mentioned by like tons of people, and then me nime mentioniwa na mtu mmoja. And I feel, I don't know how to feel. I feel good, I won't lie, I feel good. I feel like, wow, someone is actually looking at my work. You know, like there was a list of judges who are making that final nominee list, and in my head I want to think they looked at my IG and they're like, this girl deserves to be nominated under this category. And I feel good, like, even if I don't win, which of course I'm hoping I win, it's still a good feeling. It feels nice to be recognized by people that have never seen me, or like, I don't know. Please just vote for me. I think nimeongea sana. Yes. Also, I think vote of thanks was supposed to be in another video, but please be patient. Yeah. Now let's get back to the wig. If you'd like to see how I installed this wig and how I got it looking like this. Okay, I didn't mean to kuongea kasiri girl, but like, please continue watching the video. So I'm currently just laying, or rather slicking down my edges. So guys, let me show you what came in my wig. Okay, what came in the box, in the wig box. So this is how the packaging came looking like. It was closed, but the box is it's quite finuad, which I don't mind because the wig was very secure inside. I really like the packaging, it's so cute. And then once you open inside, they've written explore your hair journey, some details, and then the wig, which I'm gonna show you in a bit. So there's a thank you card, or like a card with some of their details here. Hi beautiful, thank you for shopping with your lover, etc, and their social media details. Then there's also two pieces of wig caps, which I'm gonna be using, and then a pair of lashes and some lash glue. And then the last thing that came in the box is a pair of tweezers, which I think is very, very thoughtful, especially if you'd like, you know, to tweeze the wig a bit more. And then now let me show you guys the wig. So it came in this silk dust bag, written your logo of course, and then another nylon bag, and then the wig inside, guys. Oh, like, yeah, this is the wig. Okay, it has that canette.
Okay, let me just open this really fast. This is how it looks like, straight out of the box, and then some paper to keep it in shape, and then that's how it looks like. I really like it. It just looks comfortable, like the inside just looks comfortable. And of course it has four combs, one at the front, two on the side, and one at the back, and then this adjustable strap. So I'm just gonna start the installation process and see how I can style it, because I can't wait to wear her. Anyway, yeah, so I'm just going to attempt again another bald cap, because we are not quitters here. The last time I tried it, it didn't come out as well. I'm not going to give up. The first thing you need to do when you're wearing a bald cap under your wig, obviously first is wear your wig cap, and then you want to make some holes in the area near your ears so that the cap can hang under your ears, because your ears act as the security to hold your cap before you glue it down. The next thing you're going to do is to spray some Got2b spray onto your forehead, rather like where your cap meets your forehead or your hairline basically, and make sure that you apply a very good amount and a good layer, and make sure that you pay close attention to the sides, especially near the ear, because it tends to lift a lot. And then from there you can proceed to dry using a blow dry. So once you've dried down your cap, the next thing obviously is to cut your bald cap. So for me, I started by cutting it at the center, and then as you can see, I'm not really like pulling like the excess cap so much. You just need to pull it kidogo kidogo as you cut, and then you will notice that it will just flow well and you will end up with a nice looking bald cap. I then applied my foundation on the bald cap, actually my face foundation, and then basically this is how it turned out. I actually really liked it. Using the same foundation that I used on the bald cap, I just proceeded to tint my lace.
So I've finished tinting it. It looks quite okay and nice to me. So now what I've done is I've just put it on my head so that I can measure and position it to see where I'm going to place it once I start applying my glue. And also I have cut this like the ear part of the wig off camera and like off my head also, because I'm still learning and I didn't know how to like look at it from like my head. So nimekatia tu chini, but with time hopefully I'm gonna learn that as well. But it looks pretty okay to me so far. So now I just want to cut the remaining part of the lace into smaller sections so that once I start applying my glue, it's easier for me to cut the lace. Now I'm just going to go in with my glue and then apply it on the perimeter of the cap and some on my like on my forehead. So with the glue, I'm going to apply two layers of glue, and then with each layer of glue, you want to make sure that it's completely clear and dry before you apply the next one. So let me just apply my first layer, dry it down, then apply my second layer. I'm going to be using a spatula to spread out the glue and make sure that you spread it out first before like you start flattening it.
And this is how my glue and my cap looks like after applying and drying two layers of glue. So now what I did is I just proceeded to lay down
the lace just a bit in front of where the glue was ending at. I hope I'm making sense. Just to make sure that there's no glue that was appearing at the front of the lace after I cut it. So once you lay down your wig, you don't want to immediately start pressing it until you're finally sure this is where I want it to lay. So now once you're sure, okay, this is where I want it to be at, you can start gently pressing down with your fingers so that it lays as flat as possible. And then next, I used a comb just to ensure that I laid it a bit more securely. Now I just proceeded to tie my elastic band just to ensure extra security. Please make sure you don't tighten this as much because you will get a headache if it's too tight. And then leave it for a couple of minutes before you remove it to proceed now to cut your lace. Now let's move to the cutting. As you can see, when I lifted the laces, it looked pretty secure, so I just proceeded to cut. And when you're cutting, you want to cut in a zigzag motion because it gives the wig that natural look. For cutting, guys, you need to honestly just practice. Okay, here it just hit me that I had been nominated for something, and this is how I reacted. So I cried a little bit. Anyway, let's proceed to wearing the wig. As you have seen in that previous clip, I was like pulling the hair backwards so that I could see if there's any space. And then I used the tail of my comb to apply just a small amount of glue onto these small parts that were lifting so that it could lay as seamlessly as possible. So for styling, what I did is I applied some mousse. My mousse was misbehaving, I don't know why. Then I had also previously just sprayed the hair with some water to give it this fuller look. And also I combed it out. That's why you can see the curls have loosened up. Then with the mousse and the water, I was able to achieve a wet-ish look for some part of the wig. And I think you guys can see the lace. We'll work on that so that next time I can know how to get rid of like that lace being that visible. Otherwise, I liked the install. I like how the glue sat and how it turned out.
I am done installing and styling the wig. I later on applied some mousse because my mousse was kidogo misbehaving, and this is how it turned out. I really, really like it. I love it. I love the length. It's really light. Like, it's so light on me. It's like there's nothing on my head. I don't feel like there's something on my head, actually. I think I've mentioned I didn't pluck it. I just used glue, and overall I think I did a good job today with the install. I like my bald cap. I like how I let it sit. I was very patient with it today, like nearly press leo. I liked the glue. The glue did not disappoint me or annoy me or frustrate me, and I love it. I love this wig. Also, guys, don't forget to use my code to get some money off once you decide to get yourself a wig from Yolova. I think this is where the video ends. And before I close it, thank you guys for your support. To the brands that have been, this is not the video for this, but to the brands that have been working with me, tangu, like, atani. Nikianza Tuivi, thank you so much. Yolova Hair, thank you so much for sending me this hair, and like for trusting I would do a good job. I hope you guys love the video and the tutorial. And to my subscribers, thank you. I think if I continue speaking, I'm gonna cry, and that's off brand. Yeah, so let me just end the video here and tell you guys, if you've not subscribed, please make sure you subscribe. If you subscribed, thank you. Don't forget to like, share, leave a comment, turn on the post notification bell button so that you don't miss. And also, last but not least, please, if you see this, please vote for me. Thank you. I will see you guys on my next upload. Bye. Take care of yourselves.
and the glow up been too real. Bet y'all liking what y'all see. Yeah, my mama is a soldier and my daddy is a G. When you put them two together, what you think that made me?